Hey buddy, it's John from one side of a two-car garage in the great state of Texas, and welcome to the shop. A couple of weeks ago, I had purchased a collet chuck from Banggood, a company out of China, and when I received it, the runout was just excessive. I put a video up per Banggood's request because they wanted to see the actual runout of that chuck. Well, I'm very pleased to say that Banggood handled that issue very promptly and very satisfactorily. In fact, within a matter of hours, we had a resolution where they went ahead and refunded the purchase price. And then when I got the refund, I just went ahead and ordered another collet. So this is a review of the second collet that I got and a little bit about how they handled it. The bottom line is I'm very, very pleased with the way that Banggood did that. They stepped up to the plate, totally refunded the money, and it did it promptly and very satisfactorily. So first, going to take a look at the chuck itself, and then we'll go to the lathe and measure the runout of this chuck. So let's go to the bench, talk to you about the chuck. This is the way that you receive the collet. Of course, it's shipped in the typical white plastic envelope that you receive from China. It is marked. It does come in this collapsible case. But when you open it up, what you'll find is a nicely finished, polished, and ground collet chuck. Now, the length of this collet chuck is about 5.5 inches. Now, that's with the nut on when it's tightened up. Is listed as about 5.5 inches in length, or 130 millimeters, and again, that's with the nut. The finish, both on the inside and outside, like I said, is ground and also lightly polished. The inside of this one right here is ground equally all the way around, so it looks very, very nicely inside there. The collet also has two flats on the side to tighten it with. Those flats will fit a 1-inch wrench, or approximately a 28-millimeter wrench that will go around it. Of course, I use a crescent wrench or an adjustable wrench on it, and it works perfectly on it also. The slot is wide enough where it does not interfere with your headstock or anything that's mounted. The slot itself is approximately a half or maybe 9/16 of an inch wide, so it gives you plenty of room to grip along the side. The collet nut that comes with it is also polished on the inside. It's nicely made. The problem with the first collet that I had, the nut was actually threaded wrong and it would wobble as it went on, so to speak. This one right here runs very, very truly. The threads on it work very, very smooth. It does have the 6 slots around the side for the collet wrench to work, or the spanner wrench to work. The one that I ordered did include the spanner wrench. The spanner wrench is marked on the side, ER25. It's got a red soft handle on it. It's very easy on the hands. The thickness is approximately 5 millimeters, or about 3/16 of an inch thick. The length is around 190 millimeters, or approximately 7.5 inches long. I like the way that the wrench fits. It fits very snugly, and or rather not snugly, but it fits very well. It slips in really, really easily, and it's made and positioned to turn the collet nut really, really well. And in the drawbar, it fits perfectly, or in the headstock, it fits perfectly. Actually, you can just kind of tap it in a little bit. Now, as I said before, the threads on this collet chuck here are M12 by 175. Now, you may have to make a drawbar if you're used to using the 3/8 inch drawbar in some of your collets. This one is metric, and I made a drawbar. Here's a drawbar that I made for it. I'll put this drawbar, or how to build that, or how I built this drawbar, in a separate video. But you will need, if you do not have, an M12 by 175 drawbar to drop this in your headstock. Overall, very, very pleased with this collet, and I'm very pleased with the way that Banggood handled the first one that really was just, the nut was just ground crooked where it did not thread on there very well. I'm going to go to the lathe now, and we'll check the runout on this unit.
One of the first things I want to do here is just get a reference and just show you that the headstock that we're going to be working with is true. Now, I'm turning the headstock of the lathe, and the indicator that I've got on it is half thou. So you can see that the lathe headstock is running very, very true. So we'll get any run out will be from the chuck itself. What I have in the chuck right now is a 3/8 dowel pin I have wiped the dowel pin clean and also blew the chuck out with some air, or the collet out with some air. And again, you're looking at a half thou reading, or a half thou meter, so I'm turning the collet chuck right now. And with the 3/8 dowel pin and the collet chuck, reading just slightly under half thousandth run out. I'm going to move it out towards the end a little bit and see if it makes any difference. Okay, I've moved the indicator out about 3/4 of an inch, and we'll see how we're doing right here. Not doing quite as well as what I thought it would be doing up close. Looks like we're getting, and again, that's half thou, so it looks like we're getting about a 2,500 run out on the collet chuck. So I don't know if that's the collet or the chuck or just what it is. So overall, and again, you know, these are not the most expensive things that you can buy. So if you're working for a home shop and if you can stand those tolerances, it's probably not a bad idea to go ahead and get you some of these collets and collet chucks for ease of operation. And but I'll let you make your mind up on that.
So as you can see, that chuck was a little run out, slight run out, about 2,000, maybe 2,500 run out. Now, that whole set that you saw was less than $45, and that included the collet chuck and the separate set of ER25 collets. Now, everybody's going to have different standards that they're going to be going by and looking for, and that's totally appropriate for you to do so. I'm not one of those folks that are going to try to measure everything down and spend hours and hours and hours trying to get the last half thousandth out of anything. If you've seen my videos before, you may recall that most of my projects are very small steam engines, perhaps a gas engine every once in a while, a lathe tool or a machine tool that I'll build around the shop here. In fact, most of my projects could probably be built with a mini lathe, and some, probably 50%, could be built with a little Sherline lathe or a Unimat or one of those miniature lathe type things that you see out through there. Most of the work that I do is round stock, and a lot of it is just repeatability. In other words, I'm sticking a round stock 1/8 inch brass bar, 1/2 inch this, 1/4 inch that to make a connecting rod or perhaps a crankshaft or something. So this fits my purpose perfectly. Of course, if you're running a production shop, you're probably going to be wanting to look somewhere else. Of course, you're going to also be spending a whole lot more money. So am I satisfied with this chuck? Absolutely. Am I satisfied with the way Banggood did that? Absolutely. Couldn't ask for anything better. The run out, I can accept that for what I do here in my little home hobby shop. As they say, your mileage may vary. Again, this video was not provided by Banggood. They had nothing invested in this. This is just my reply to the way that they handled a good customer service situation. Guys, join me back in the shop soon. Until that time, this is John from one side of a two-car garage in the Upper East Side of Texas. We'll see you next time.